Defence expenditure as a share of the total central government expenditure has seen an increase to 13.88% from 13.23% in the year 2014-15. And defence outlay, when viewed in the context of the total central government non-plan outlay, maintains its share at around 18.8%, which is quite similar to 2014-15. And finally, defence expenditure, this defence allocation this year accounts for 1.75% of the GDP, proposed GDP of rupees 141 lakh crore. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, our chief guest for the day is the Chairman of the Department of Standing Committee for Defence. Sir has twice served as the Chief Minister of Uttarakhand and has also served as a Cabinet Minister in the Ministry of Service Council. Major General P. Sikhanduri, ADSM. Sir, may I please invite you for the inaugural address?
CDA, Mr. Kaushal, National CDA, distinguished panelists, participants, ladies and gentlemen, Namaskar. It is my pleasure to be here today in the symposium of Defence Budget 2015-16. As the chairperson of the Standing Committee on Defence, it has been our attempt and priority to ensure that defence forces are well equipped and well prepared in terms of modern arms, ammunition and equipment. And adequate is our made available for this purpose, hence defence budget is very important from this perspective. It is not only relating only to defence forces but the entire country and its security. We, the Standing Committee, critically reviewed the budget last year and we are charged with the duty of doing the same this year. The details of budget pertaining to defence ministry will now be worked out based on the general budget. There is an impression that has been presented and so everything is available to us. It is not so. The Ministry of Defence is going to take another few days, I think about 2 weeks or so, before she can analyze it and issue the detailed instructions. I don't know if they are continued now, but this is a procedure I understand. And even for Defence Committee to examine critically all the aspects, it takes another 10 or 15 days before we can get the detailed work out of the Ministry of Defence. But here today, I do not intend, nor do I think I have the capability to discuss the details and ingredients. The lady here just now discussed generally on the basis of what available information. But we in the Defence Committee, I also happen to be an SRM officer, but there are people, other people who do not have experience of service for this particular. And there are including 31 officers. So what I intend to do, I do not want to get into details of
get a briefing from the Ministry of Defence officials, including the Secretary, and then make a suggestion. But that, as I told you, will take only after Defence Ministry has discussed the proposal. And as I said earlier, the body, the CGDA, etc., will be made also give the report to the Ministry of Defence. So I do not take the crop of me here today to go to the nitty-gritties of the Defence budget.
statement that made by the CG, the different budget that you plan. And not funding for villages and all that. This is a major issue which I will be giving you my feelings about subject. But this needs to be talked. Even budget is declining. Now, in terms of actual money, we have increased. Every time you say this is budget, there is so much percent. But if you say the actually, if you include the cost of inflation, then it is reducing. And sometimes reducing very drastically. Not in good thing, good thing for the circuit. Other thing I want to share with you, and your forum, you can look into this. We in the country have got an inferiority complex. We want to compare what percentage of GDP is going into defense services. And then we compare 3.5%, and we get worried that internationally we talked about. And historically, some of senior officers may know about it. Today, the bottom has been brought into defense. After so many years of independence, we have realized that this is not the right way of thinking. In 1962, when the Chinese opposition took place, and soon after this border road organization created, this generally was created as general reserve engineer force. That is a force, uniform force. And therefore, at that time, particularly whatever wisdom people had at that time, they said, internationally, we should not go over a certain percentage of GDP. I request you all to kindly examine this in detail, that why should we relate our defense expenditure in terms of GDP of any other country? Suddenly, we have no frontiers, no problems. I think our country is the situation where we are the worst of as far as threats are concerned. And therefore, this concept of taking care of GDP, I think, is counterproductive, is unnecessary. I'd also like to discuss this issue in your deliberations here and make some recommendations which is not proper to the interest of the country and not merely humoring the international community in regard to GDP. And that is why this border road, I've been Minister of Road Transport and Highways, under which border road is working. And the type of priority border roads are given is nowhere near the idea that was conceived in 1962. And I have personal experience with this, I have raised it many times. Then this force was raised. Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru used to come and preside over the meeting himself. And the meeting was held quite often. All in a period of time, it was diluted. And then different ministers started coming. As time passed by, and we started lecturing, the Minister of State started coming. And recently I asked them, how often does the minister should come? And when I was minister in the road transport, I said, how often is it being added? No, you have for months, yes. So this is the type of mental block that you have created for sir, as the defense is concerned. It's a good thing that the thinking is changing now. We have a government and a prime minister who understands and is willing to appreciate the threats and take measures to the extent it is possible to counter those threats. This gentleman, I just wanted to tell you in terms of GDP and the general perception of our budget, the money that we are giving to them, it is not something which you can trade off. The threat is not trade off. You can't trade off, by the way, I mean, not fight on this front, but let me reduce the budget. It is not that. It cannot be that. In our country, you know what type of threats are there? Apart from external threats, two very big countries, internet threats are there, internet problems are there. And therefore, when you discuss the budget proposal, and at and from your side, if things on things, the results or the effectiveness are based on these issues also, that should be there. Because otherwise, CGs are thrown mind, may say. But otherwise, personal money is not even cutting. Jitna kaatna kaat le jao, acha hai. So, this is your duty to see that waste is very generating. But let us understand the waste. Why should we take from 1962 to 2016 to understand that there is no point telling border road issue when there is Minister of Highways and telling the border that I want 3.5% GDP, I am 3.4. That makes no sense. And the result has been that priorities are there. And I said, I don't blame anybody else. I have been Minister in the district. The priority is not to Gobindu agenda. The money is to be given somewhere, and priority is to be given. We give it to other things. They are more important than national peace, more important than cutting bridges, more important than cutting people. So this type of perception, I think, we should turn away. It's a very good thing, and I congratulate this government. They have taken a very major step. You give whatever money you want to give, give it in hands to the people. And defense ministry is accountable. Today we have gone wrong, Germany has gone wrong, we want to go right up to the borders, international borders, Nusula event, roads are in terrible condition. You don't get equipment, you don't get money. I mean, you are sitting in bed, you can't imagine. There's a place where perpetually you're at 30, 40 feet of meters of snow. And on that you have to cut a rope, make a rope. So this sort of thing, if accountability in the defense ministry, and money be controlled by Ministry of Road Transport, that is not work. So I think it's a very good step that has been taken place. And I would like you to also give you work, detailed examination, and what benefits are provided. Now coming on to the defense budget of 2015, as I put it, I am not giving you too much nitty gritty, but one of the things that has come to my mind and I will share with you today, and I hope you will consider it worthwhile to examine. We have this, this concept of capital expenditure and revenue expenditure. And what happens? You will know better, I assume, at the end of this, capital budget can be reduced because the competition will come, there is billion, and the revenue demands are there. There are more credits and pay requirements, more requirements, credits will shift, capital budget into revenue. This goes on and on. Nothing will do better. You correct me if I am wrong. But this concept does not work. Then whom does it help? You have to meet enemies. 7 million for capital and 3 for revenue. At the end of the day, I am spending 7 rupees on revenue and 3 rupees on capital. What do you use? Why can't you pay back in the thinking? So my suggestion to you all is, please look at this aspect. The capital expenditure should be 1790, not negotiable and not transferable. And people, separate set of people should be accountable. Not the same people who are looking after the revenue budget. Revenue is a problem. There is a requirement, there is a deficit, there is a shortage. But I feel that revenue budget under the US Ministry should be a separate setup which is not interchangeable with the revenue. I am saying this in the retired army officer. I will be hard in pinch because then revenue will have to be more. But there is no point fully concerned. And I told you I give 10 rupees in our planning. 7 rupees I give to at the end of the year I know after 7 I have only spent 3. What to do? Shift forward. So, two separate teams in the CDA should be there, one for tackling capital thing, and that should be a separate sort of budget under the ministry, which is accountable, which is concentrated totally on the capital thing. Why things are not coming? Why did it take place? Why so many charges of corruption are coming? You look into that, that will be the entire responsibility. And then make it a roll-on plan. If I have given it 10 rupees this year, don't say I shall show 3 taps. 3 will go on. Let them be known because you have worked it out based on the cost of traffic equipment that you want to make. The cost is increasing, not increasing. So what's the idea of lapse in the fund? So this sort of concept of revenue and capital should be separated out and not interchangeable, I mean, not accountable to the same agency which is doing. Because it is easy when money is required for non-capital revenue items, and we are busy, we are transferring. So, whole year don't you pay much attention. So, this capital in my business of capital and the people also should be very important. Next, this is also important for capital. Because, why do you want to every year examine the The other thing is that when you talk of our capital items, why should we give the MDA? There are a lot of senior officers here, spirit people. You have the threat perception, ladies and gentlemen, is decided at the topmost level. What is the threat perception this year or next 2-3 years? Where is the threat perception? The war machine is designed.
War machine means weapons, equipment systems, human beings, and the other administrative facilities that we got. So they then decided, and they cannot be commissioned. We don't want to anything. If you have a district person, sir, this is your war machine. What do you do here? You can go even this region. In fact, personality and limit. What do you do here? Maybe you have this people that are from, where's the elder? What is the corruption? Some inquiry is going on. So, this threat perception, and as I said, I'm going to have the capital expenditure not being examined frequently, examined on the basis when it is required, then only is worthwhile. At the moment, we are carrying out 50 years exercise just for the sake of form and nothing much is permissible. So, therefore, I have to pursue all the remedies examined from this person also. The threat perception, the revenue expenditure, the capital expenditure, how it should be managed, how should be organized, how should be accountable, and things are not coming, our equipment or our charges of corruption. I also want to take the time has come. When we take it seriously, look into this concept of charges being floated. Anybody who can get a contract can float the charge, and the senior inquiry starts. None of your officers or even officers at the union, nobody wants to take a chance. Don't do any work. You are safe. You will do work and you will caught. This is another attribute thing of the problem. So therefore, this idea also, this delegation here would like to examine it. And what is the concept of ensuring that our capital requirements are may be given? Duty, allegations of corruption do not interfere with sincere people. It should make people, good people, stop working. And troublemakers having trouble. This is the system in our country. So many cases are given after all, world over, things are going on. And if there are manageable corruption, I mean, it will be very awkward. I think that manageable corruption, don't your security be compromised just because some minor issue of allegation is gone. This is just separate. Have that whatever you want to do. But the threat person is built in a country. What is the use of having 20 inquiries and then war start tomorrow? They are caught naked. What is the use? There's no point. So these are the issues which I think the organization and the agency and the think tank of our country is concentrated on this basic problem today that we are not prepared for. We have two major fronts. And I don't have the internal details available with me. I am not going to that. But my perception is a civil as a nation, personally as a citizen, is that we have keep on doing better. Something happens here, we said, we are not on the ground position with the war machine. And with the war machine, and the men machine potential. We are not considered people, such as a threat. We are hoping this threat will come and that will not come. Or that will come and this will not come. This sort of attitude, I think, is